thoughts on getting into some game action here?
Just really looking forward to it. It's been a couple weeks that I've been, you know, nursing a bit of an injury, but it's nice to be able to be active and to go into this game and play for my first regular season debut in CFL.
Are you going to spend most of your game check on tickets, the way things are looking?
You know what? Since I'm from there, the majority of my family and friends were already going to be going to the game. So I lucked out. I don't have to buy too many tickets, but I got some for my girlfriend and a couple friends. So a couple dollars on tickets.
How much does it add to it? I mean, not only is it your debut, but it is in your hometown or close to it, isn't it?
Well, I mean, it's definitely something special. I grew up watching the Ticats and going to Ticats games. So it's pretty nice, but hopefully you can go down there and get a favorable result for the Riders this week.
So your first pro game at the University of Guelph?
Yeah, first pro game at the University of Guelph, and I never actually played there at their new stadium. I played at the old one they had, but yeah, it should be a pretty fun debut.
So what type of Ticat fan were you? Were you all dressed up in their colors, or were you really a fanatic?
I wouldn't call myself too much of a fanatic, but like I said, I did go to quite a few games when I was a kid and, you know, growing up. And last year I went to a couple games and I was thinking, you know, there's a chance I could be playing in the CFL next year. So here we are, and it's pretty cool to be playing my first game there.
How did you react when you heard the news?
I was pretty happy about it. I mean, it's something special to be able to just play in this league and then, like I said, to debut at my hometown. And it's actually my birthday today, so it's a nice little birthday present, I guess. So hopefully we can get a win and add to it.
What do you think the expectations are for you this week?
Just go out there and work hard and do what I'm asked. I'm going to be playing a lot on teams and everything, so just try and keep things rolling with the guys that are already on teams and, you know, try and just work my hardest and contribute to a good team win.
When you see the guy, I guess, essentially you're replacing Scott McHenry, you see kind of what he went through to get to where he is today. Do you see that as a similar path and an inspiration in a sense?
Oh, absolutely. I think the way Scotty, you know, worked himself into being a good fullback in this league is something that, you know, I could learn from. And he's a great guy, and he helped mentor me in training camp, and as well did Neil Hughes. So I'm just trying to learn as much as I can every day and just come to work and work hard.
How different is the position?
It's quite different. I mean, I played slot back at McMaster and then some tight end and lots of special stuff. So it was an adjustment, but being a big-bodied guy and I'm not afraid to block guys, I picked it up fairly quickly and I'm enjoying it and just hopefully just can continue to get better at it.
Spencer Moore was tweeting this morning that he's about ready to make his debut in Hamilton. Is that your understanding of his status?
Oh, he is? Yeah. Good for him. He probably just means he's coming to the game. He might be flying to the game. But no, he's a young guy that I hope to see do some good things. So, you know, he'll make the move up. So it'll be good to see him play and see what he can do.
Does he just go in for McHenry, or what's, how does that
work? Yeah, he'll make a move for McHenry.
How much is an advantage? You're moving him to fullback, but he was a receiver in college, and that, again, versatility paying off.
He's a big dude. I'll tell you that. I just told Coach Dice that earlier. I said, he is a big dude, but that's one of the things. I think he's a draft steal if he can pan out, you know, because one thing we saw him play like some tight end, some fullback, more tight end and receiver when he's at McMaster. So him playing a little bit of receiver, a little bit of fullback, is very big to have those type of versatile guys. And I'm sure George, he's a good coach, and he knows how to maneuver guys with their versatility.